Spotting scope, kind of.
Hours you pills check, snake bite kit.
Nope,
that's fine. We don't need that. Tire goo?
A little bit.
All right. Big old bag of charcoal.
Yes.
Sure.
Okay. Fuel?
Yes.
Plenty.
Check.
Yes.
Compass?
Yes.
Solar panel?
Yes.
Locky?
Yes.
Camp stove?
Yep.
Chairs?
Yes.
Yep.
Okay. Trash bags?
Yes.
Water?
Yes.
Cooking bench, we got rid of that. Tools, ammo cans? Yes.
Yes.
Voltimeter?
Yes.
Okay. Bailing wire, we don't need that. Or did you bring it?
I would like to. We should get that.
sunscreen, check. Lighter, check. Saw, check. Dremel, check. Dremel?
We don't have a Dremel. It's just to remind us to get it.
Wagon? Yes. Bike pump?
Yes.
Inverter? No. We got chargers. Pokers? Yes. Bean pot? Check. Pan? Check. Dry ice in the cooler. First aid kit in my backpack. Toe strap? Okay.
We'll figure that out later.
We got a toe strap.
Lamps?
Yeah.
Carb cleaner.
Yeah.
Oil.
No, ish.
A little bit. Lucas.
Hot dogs. Yes, we got all the food. Yes?
Yes.
Okay. Booze. Burnettes and whiskey.
Yes.
Okay. Plates, bowls, spoons, cups, coffee cups, paper towels.
Yes.
Is that fucking a little number, not enough PC?
Yeah, because the issue is like, hey, the poor guy who has to bleep out our fucking words. And not to mention, we can't talk about tranny fluid anymore.
Gender neutral shift limit. Is that, I thought that truck was on the tracks.
It is going quite quickly. You gonna make it?
No trains.
No trains you can see.
Yeah.
Hark!
Bell Burner Classic.
The invisible train. Oh my god, it might, I'm sorry for flipping over the camera, guys. You'll just have to fucking deal with it.
Tons.
We're running a pretty low budget operation here.
Stop!
It's gonna be like the mid 500 with Giant Death not in the car and all those cars passed him. With his beard.
Oh. Kawasaki!
When's that lawnmower dam work?
It's middle of May.
Mm. I'll need a new engine by then.
I'll need something.
I like my body a lot. It's a good body. I just, the engine is not worth trusting. And for what, like $150, I can buy a brand spanking new motor. I mean, it saves me more time than fucking pulling it apart, right?
Right.
Unless, of course, I chose a mower where, oh yeah, you can't change the instant on these things. want to get a shot of us walking Cal.
Go ahead.
Wah!
This is next time. We're figuring out what we need for next time. If we had just like plug in headphones for those radios, like we could probably hear, and then when we talk, we put it right up to our mouth, so it'll probably come over clear enough. Yeah.
What all I've gathered. This is it's some kind of ancient landing site. Sort of, like
oh, I'm fucking thinking.
It's like, what? You're like, let's fucking think about it. Right? It took a fucking 360 seat. Fucking no one.
No. This is fucking government conspiracy.
He's a fucking nuclear.
He's fucking. He's a fucking nuclear test crater.
Oh.
Yeah. No. This is fucking nuclear glass. Oh. This fucking from
let's
the
get
test. This fucking sample. Oh yeah.
He's fucking nuclear glass right there.
Yeah, I'll forget the fucking technical term, but it's fucking probably highly radioactive.
Oh yeah, I can taste the fucking uranium.
Okay. Fucking diddy bomb. Oh, look at that fucking road going through that canyon over there.
Fucking dirty bombs,
it's been only about an hour since we started. We're already drinking green stuff, and I guess the boys are still hanging in there. Everything's running good. Stay tuned.
Oh, close to me. I'm nowhere near pro. Ah, I'm deaf.
Hey, it's Avery. This is your humble editor of the film. So this area was called Tank Range, and there really wasn't much to see out there. It's where they take the light infantry vehicles and the tanks to do some target ranges, and on our way back, we actually saw some burnt-out carcasses of some cars, so that was pretty cool to see. But there really wasn't much out here. It was just straight roads. There were no trails or anything like that. It was honestly quite boring. The roads were full of sharp rocks. It was boring, and it was a little treacherous at times. The only thing of significance that actually happened out here was I tipped the trailer over, and that was basically it. The rest of it was just basically an hour and a half of straight roads, and you know, it was interesting to see, but photography wise there wasn't much to show, so I just decided to cut that little bit out just to save time on the video, because it's already a little long in my opinion.
Down. No, I won't back down. You can stand me up at the gates of hell, but I won't back down. Gonna stand my ground, won't be turned around, and I'll keep this world from dragging me down. Gonna stand my ground, and I won't back down. Hey, baby,
so far back.
There ain't no easy way out.
Man, I'm so impressed you didn't flip the wagon once. Almost.
You
didn't flip the wagon. Yeah, not flip, but it was on the side. We had to flip. That's not flipped.
I mean, it wasn't completely upside down.
Upside down.
That's just because I wasn't paying attention. I fucking hate that.
That fucking soft edge.
I know. Even it was all of your guys' fault for even getting close.
Well, I was filming, and I got a little bit close, right, and then just ate my tire.
It's a nasty edge, especially with like the further down one.
Oh, I was a little. Remember when we went off the Land Cruiser? I was a little nervous about getting back along. It was so fucking soft.
What's your favorite part of the day, guys?
I like crop circle.
Was good.
Yeah.
The first
tank maze was a little bit of a letdown.
Yeah, it was a bit long. Like, I didn't realize how big that was.
It was really long. And the road was terrible.
I know. I did not like the street roads.
It was awful. I like the trails are so much nicer than the main roads. I was like, one of us is going to pop a tire, and that's going to be so shitty.
No, I won't back down.
This is the part of the trip where we're halfway through and we're answering questions for the audience. Susie from Iowa asks, "Hey Avery, how windy was it yesterday?" And to that, Susie, I'm going to answer, pretty fucking windy.
How do you feel like your tractor did?
I feel like my tractor did pretty good, actually. The old Yardmaster, not bad. Starting it, it doesn't like to start. But going, it's faster than everything, other piece of garbage out here. And it tows shit. So, honestly, I think 10 out of 10 would do again.
You care to explain what happened in your little rollover accident yesterday?
Yeah, so, oh, by the way, there's a military base right over there. Anyways, the road coming up to this camp spot has some ditches on the side of it. And I was fidgeting with my vest. I went in. And the trailer went over, and we spilled a lot of fluids, some flammable, some not.
Yeah, it's whatever.
It's whatever.
What would you do different?
Bring a car.
No, that's cheating.
Oh, what would I mean, like, I don't know. Really nothing. I'm pretty. I mean, let me think. More pants. Bring more pants, probably. But that's really my only complaint.
And how'd your cot tent do?
Oh, it did wonderful. With the wind, I was afraid the wind was going to take us about a mile and a half that way, but I think it did wonderful.
Aside from the fact it was filled with water?
Okay, listen, it's not my fault it's a really well-made tent, okay? I didn't even have that much water inside of me. The condensation in there is incredible.
It's like a cold sauna.
Yes, we started.
It was day two, and we didn't really bring paper towels. I brought this thin-ass jacket, so it's a little chilly. There's no sun. There's a bit of wind.
You know, I just thought it would be a much better crowbar.
Bottom of my sleeping bag's wet.
Mm-hmm.
My tent rattled like a freaking steel roofed house in Kansas in the middle of a tornado. So loud.
So we didn't bring any firewood. What do we use for burning shit?
Well, cow patties work really well. Mm. We're doing this straight cowboy. I mean, they burn just incredible.
Can you cite a certain movie that gave you that idea, or just your cowboy instincts?
True Grit. I'm Rooster Cogburn.
Would you do anything different?
My machine is mighty. Maybe tighten my umbrella. Keeps whapping me in the head.
Really?
Yep.
What was the worst part of the trip yesterday for you?
Oh, the terrible straight road. All the trails are nice.
Yeah.
But the road, the actual improved road, is garbage. It has massive pointy rocks just wanting to pop your tires. And we can't go our top speed on that road.
Looks like you're very troubled by this.
Yeah, it's terrible. And the wind. This morning's not bad, though. This fire is excellent.
Oh, yeah. Anything else you'd like to declare?
The coffee's too dark. That's it.
What's up?
I like it.
So, day two. Anything to declare?
Cal needs to bring warmer clothes. I don't have to hear a bitch and moan about it.
Mm. What would you do differently?
Bring a bigger lighter. Bring lots of various tapes, like electrical tape and duct tape.
Yeah, I felt the tape was necessary.
Honestly, I probably would have brought a different cot tent. That one's a little bitch to put up. Kind of rattly, but other than that, it worked fine.
Gotcha.
It was fine.
Best part about yesterday?
Probably the initial hour.
Hmm.
We were first on the trails and we were breaking everything in.
That was a good time. Fun. Yeah.
My butt started hurting when we got to the highway.
That was pretty miserable.
Yeah, it just kept going.
Do you have anything else to say?
We're very good at making fire with nothing.
Yeah, that we are. That we are.
Well,
Well, the nothing that's around us.
I mean, except for the briquettes and carb cleaner. That's how you get a fire started. I won't sit on this.
Let's ride.
As I walk through the valley where I harvest my grain, I take a look at my wife and realize she's very plain. But that's just perfect for an Amish like me. You know I shun fancy things like electricity. At 4:30 in the morning, I'm milking cows. Jebediah feeds the chickens and Jacob plows. Fool, and I've been milking and plowing so long that even Ezekiel thinks that my mind is gone. I'm a man of the land, I'm into discipline. Got a Bible in my hand and a beard on my chin. But if I finish all of my chores and you finish thine, then tonight we're gonna party like it's 1699. We've been spending most our lives living in an Amish paradise. A churn butter once or twice, living in an Amish paradise. It's hard work and sacrifice, living in an Amish paradise. We sell quilts at discount price, living in an Amish paradise. A local boy kicked me in the butt last week. I just smiled at him and I turned the other cheek. I really don't care, in fact I wish him well. 'Cause I'll be laughing my head off when he's burning in hell. But I ain't never punched a tourist even if he deserved it. An Amish with a tool, you know that's unheard of. I never wear buttons, but I got a cool hat. And my homies agree I really...
Avery, you care to explain what I'm looking at here?
Yeah, come a little closer. Come in my office here.
Let me just on over.
So when... Let me get nice and personal for you. When a mommy and a daddy love each other very much, they have vicious sex, and that's how most people are made. They don't want to think about that, but that's how it is. And then when they have these babies, and these babies make other friends with other babies, the other babies tell the other babies to take lawnmowers into the wilderness and overland with them. Now sometimes those lawnmowers, the fucking belt breaks, and then you have to have your friend's mower, which, by the way, in no way or shape or form should be outperforming that mower in any way, has to tow it back. They say this is God's country, but I don't know, man. After what we went through last night. Hey, did you know that a tent cot can hold about a gallon of water, like fresh water? So, survival tip: if you can store your water in a cot tent, it won't leak out. But anyways, last day we're going home, and I think we're all very excited to do that.
Thank you.
there have been so many recalls? Recalls for what? For food in general.
We did it. We fucking did it.
And I got minimal injuries.
You know what's crazy? The speed we're traveling at now is probably five times as fast as the lawnmower is traveling. And that device went out on reading. We probably could have idled there in half the time.
Oh, we probably could have. Just a suggestion. I think the mowers could probably be a, something we take somewhere and tootle with them. While I enjoyed the overlanding trip, it seemed a bit much.
It was difficult.
But it was difficult.
We did prove ourselves.
I did enjoy the challenge. Thanks for letting me borrow this hat, by the way. It did some fucking work. Kept me nice and safe. Any regrets?
Not a one. Liquor.
Huh?
Liquor.
Liquor. I barely know her.
That's probably my own.
We'll meet again. Don't know where. Don't know when, but I know we'll meet again some sunny day. Keep smiling through, just like you always do, till the blue skies drive the dark clouds far away. And will you please say hello to the folks that I know? Tell them that I won't be long, and they'll be happy to know that as you saw me go, I was singing this song. We'll meet again, don't know where, don't know when, but I know we'll meet again some sunny day. Yeah, we'll meet again. I don't know where, and I don't know when, but I do know that we'll meet again some sunny day. So honey, keep on smiling through, just like you always do, till the blue skies drive the dark clouds far away. And would you please say hello to all the folks that I know, and tell them I won't be long. They'll be happy to know that as you saw me go, I was singing this song. We'll meet again, don't know where, don't know when, but I know we'll meet again some sunny day.